Hello students, in this video we are going to see Java programming topic, that is inter-thread communication. Okay, so let us see the first of all concept of the inter-thread communication. Now inter-thread communication means what? When two or more threads are communicate with each other by exchanging the message between them, it is called inter-thread communication. So we have written the definition on the board. When two or more threads are communicate with each other by exchanging the message between them, it is called inter-thread communication. Now inter-thread communication is occur when threads are changing their states. Now when inter-thread communication will occur, when threads are changing their states. Now we have seen the life cycle of thread. In that we have seen that the thread having various states. Thread goes through the newborn state, runnable state, running state, blocked state and dead state. Now in this particularly, when threads are switching from runnable or running state into blocked state, or when threads are switching from blocked state to runnable or running state, then inter-thread communication will occur. Now for this switching the state of the threads, some methods are used. Now we are going to see the methods. Now which methods are used? Now first is notify, second is notify all, and third is wait. These methods are responsible for the threads inter-thread communication. Now let us see first method, notify. Now syntax is written as final await notify. Now why it is final? This method is inherited from the object class. Object class is super class of the all classes. Now this notify method means this method is informed to the first blocked thread to come back to the runnable state and subsequently running state. So here inter-thread communication will occur. What I told you, notify method, when it is called, it informs to the first blocked thread to switch into runnable state and subsequently running state. Now second method, notify all. This method is also belonging to the object class. The syntax is final await notify all. Now this method is informed to all blocked thread. Now here all word is written so that this method is informing to the all blocked thread to switch into runnable state and subsequently running state. Now third method, wait thread. Now its operation or its function is opposite to the notify. Now when wait method is called, it informs to the active thread to switch into blocked state. Okay, the syntax is final await wait. This method is also belonging to the object class, inherited into the thread class. Okay, so I hope that you understand this concept. Okay, thank you.